Importing data from an Excel worksheet into R can be easily done with the readxl package. Use install.packages to install it, make sure to put it into quotation marks. Afterwards, simply use the library function to load this package. After that's done, you can additionally set the working directory, make sure to put the working directory into quotation marks. In my case, it's under C and R scripts. You can also see your working directory here. Next up, you can now use the readxl function. The first step after loading it is creating a new data frame, df. Make sure to use the read_xl function, and now you have the option to simply name the file if it's within your working directory, which you've just set here, or you can specify the direct path to it. So in this case, I'm lazy and I'm just copying this one and put the file name behind it. So it's a data.xlsx file. I can already run this function and you can see that the import has succeeded. The second option you have is using the file.choose function. If you run this one, you will get the explorer and you can choose your file freely. The following additional arguments will still be required in case they apply. Usually, if your data is somewhat clean, the import will succeed frictionless. If you have, for example, more than one worksheet within your file, you can use the sheet argument, which will allow you to specify the number or the exact name of your sheet. If it's the second sheet, just put 2 in it. If it has a certain name, for instance data2, simply put data2 within quotation marks. So either string or number work. In case you have missing values, you can use the NA argument and then put capital NA in quotation marks to mark it as NA values. In case you have non-data related rows and columns in your worksheet, you can use the range argument. The range argument requires you to put the range in quotation marks, for instance if you have the cell B1 until C257. This will only import the data that is within this range. If you only want to skip rows above your data, use the number of lines within the skip argument. For instance, if you want to skip the first 3 lines, use skip equals 3. Another helpful argument is trim_WS. WS is for whitespace, and you can remove trailing and leading whitespace within your cells if you put it under equals true. If you have column names within your first row, they will be used without any further argument. You can however specify your own names with the col_names argument. Just make sure to put a C in front and then in quotation marks, for instance row 1, and then in quotation marks row 2, and so forth. My advice is to change it in Excel beforehand though. All other existing arguments, which will only apply in certain cases, can be found in the documentation for the readxl package. Simply select the read_xl function and press the F1 key to open the documentation to see all further arguments that can be used.